Hello YouTube, this is HellBuddy. I made this video about PHP day time zone set. When you use PHP day function to echo out the current day time, if you get warning message like that, the message displays in front of the day time string is pretty annoying. So, what's e-warning? When we check on php.net, the note told us, since PHP 5.1.0, when the day time functions were rewritten, every call for this daytime functions will generate a e-notice or e-warning message if the time zone wasn't setting. PHP wants the day function becomes more accurate. If you use PHP version is 5 or greater than 5, you had better pay attention for it. We have three solutions for it. The first one is you can change the default time zone sets in your ini file. That would be much more convenient. It won't show warning again if you forget to set the time zone. However, it's a little bit complicated sometimes if you didn't really handle it well. I'm not going to cover this topic on this video, so maybe follow up later. But when you carefully to read the message, it's already told you the answer. The second is, I know some people will use error reporting this function and put 0 into the parentheses to close out the warning, but beware. It maybe also close out the other important message, so I'm not recommend for it. If you can't change default time zone on your ini file for some reasons, or you need to create a new time zone set website, so the third one is the right way and get more easier. Use the default time zone set function into the parentheses. Put the time zone identifier as my local time zone area, America, New York. And let's save the file. Refresh the browser. The warning is gone. Display the daytime string normally. You can follow the link, go to my website. I set the reference demo. You can try it. Select different time zone identifier and day string format. It will display different result. For example, I choose the area American Phoenix with full textual day string format. Click run to run out all the information. It will show the format day string, time zone set identifier which you choose, and some PHP codes. Let's show my local time clock. I'm in New York. Now here is October 28, 2014, around 12 a.m. But in Phoenix, it's October 27, around 9 p.m. The time zone is 3 hours different between each other. It would be much convenient for using time zones identifier. You don't need to create a new time function to interval the different hours, only use one function and do everything for you. The following is the example about the day string format. Lowercase d is 2 digits days of month. Uppercase of s, this English suffix for days of month. Uppercase of f, this is full textual of month. Uppercase of y, this is 4 digits of year. Lowercase of g, this is 12 hours format of hour. Lowercase of I, this is minutes. Lowercase of s, this is seconds. The big A displays uppercase of AM or PM. Lowercase of L is full textual of day of week. By the way, I will use space, dash, and colons to split the string. The last one is using uppercase T in day string format. That is the great thing with using time zone set function. It will echo out abbreviation of the specific time zone's identifier. You can copy the code and run on your PHP page. Let's see how it works. Also, follow the link source, go to php.net. You can copy the time zones list where you like and some reference on day format string page. How to make your own daytime poststamp or current day timestamp like that with using time zone set function? That's very easy. Let me duplicate all these codes and then break down all this into different day format string function. Copy this. Let's cut it. All right. And then put them into different variables. Like this is day, month, year, time, and the week of day, and the time zone abbreviate. Let me add some breaks to let your guys easy to read it to the browser. So save the page and refresh the browser. Oh, I get error. Let's see. Oh, I'm using the equals right here. Okay. So you can see now all echoes individually upon each variable. You can use div or, for example, HTML table, and then put each variable into the table cell. And then let me echo this variable with using PHP code. Just like this. You can put the variable into anywhere or whatever presentation you like.